At the early onset of the pandemic, when most people were staying home and schools were remote, we were seeing very few pediatric cases. Over the summer and as we've headed into the fall, we've seen an increase in the number of children who are testing positive for coronavirus. We are seeing more hospitalizations. We're seeing more kids sick who have other health conditions. And we really don't understand the long-term implications of coronavirus infection in pediatric patients yet.
You know, the risks of COVID-19 in children are not insignificant. And in my career as a pediatric hospitalist, I've seen many, many children working hard to breathe and short of breath from viral infections in general. This is a really scary spot for children and their parents. And I don't want anybody to be in that position where they have to watch their child working hard to breathe.
When we start to talk about numbers and even numbers of risk of vaccine versus COVID, sometimes we talk about numbers and we forget that these are people, that kids tend to do okay with COVID infection, but not all of them do. And even those small numbers, those are somebody's sons and daughters and grandkids.
The truth is that parenting is really hard, right? Like, and this is an uncertain world and we can never know anything 100%, but to the degree that we can know it, you know, these vaccines are safe and effective for use and really help decrease the risk of serious illness in our communities. If we have the opportunity to prevent these outcomes, then that's a gift, you know, because these experiences are some of the hardest ones that I've ever seen families go through.